Welcome back to Vision Academy. This is the seventh and last lecture on normal distribution. In this lecture, you will all learn how to find the value of mu and standard deviation. There are some situations where mu and standard deviation are unknown. In such situation, using inverse cumulative probability distribution of normal curve we will find mu and standard deviation. This is a very important lecture. Kindly watch the whole video. Let us consider our problem for that. In this problem, we have 2x information. Let us read a problem. In a normal distribution, 10% of the items are over 125 and 35% are under 60. Then using these 2x information, we have to find mean and standard deviation of the distribution. Before moving into the problem, first of all, we need to realize the percentage in the normal curve. As I told you already, normal curve or normal distribution is expressed in terms of probability. The probability is equal to 1%, sorry, 1, which is also equal to 100%. When we express this 100% in terms of proportion, we will consider this as 1. If so, we have to locate this 10% and 35% in the normal curve firstly, then we can calculate mean and standard deviation of the respected distribution. And one more thing you must keenly observe in this information is, in a normal distribution, 10% of the items are over 125. You have to think whether upper tail or lower tail this 10% items are falling. I will tell you how this is going to fall. Consider this is a normal curve. In this, right side is upper tail and left side is lower tail. So let us read the problem again. In a normal distribution, 10% of items are over 125. So here over 125 means it must fall in the upper tail, because this is a case of above. Above means above then or over than mu. So we have to consider 10% of the right side or upper tail region. Since upper tail region having 50% in the probability, which means 0.5 to the right side and 0.5 to the left side, out of 50%, which has to cover 10%. And on the other side, and 35% are under 60. Which means under 60, we have to consider under 60. Under 60 means below than mu. So which means in the lower tail, 35% are under 60 out of 50%. So if you see that in the probability, this is a shaded area. This 35% is covered in the lower tail of the region. So this 35% in the lower tail and 10% in the upper tail. So firstly, we must be very clear about this. When we unknown about mu and standard deviation, we have to follow this percentage wise calculation, that is association type of calculation, association to the mu. Using this association, we can find mu and standard deviation. If 35% are covered 60 items, which means x is equal to 60, and since we don't know the x, z score for x is equal to 60, we will consider z is equal to minus z1. Let us consider x 60 is a z1, which I have taken in the negative sign, because which is falling in the lower tail. And on the other hand, another x is equal to 125, which is 10% of items over 125. So x here z is equal to z2. Let us consider x 125 as z2 and x 60 as z1. So center always will be the mu, and the z value for mu is always will be 0. So moving further, again we have to give solution this problem through using standard normal variate. For that, we have to assume x follows normal distribution, where mu and variance must follow normal distribution, and where mu and variance are unknown and are to be obtained using necessary procedure. So very importantly, here we are given that probability of x greater than 125, which means over 125 is 10%. 10% is converted into fraction, that 10 by 100 would be 0.1. And probability of x lesser than 60, because 60 items are under 35%. So again, 35 by 100 is converted into fraction, 0.35. We know that if x follows normal distribution where mu and variance, then we have to follow the standard normal variate. The formula for standard normal variate is equal to z is equals to x minus mu by standard deviation. So let us consider x1, that z1 and z2 further. We have to put those z1 and z2 into the form equation. Firstly, let us consider x equals to 60. So here just I have replaced the value whatever we have. We have only x is equal to 60 and we are unknown about mu and standard deviation. And that would be equation 1. So minus z1, which falls in the lower tail of the region, and which is equation 1. And we do have one more x here, that is x equals to 125. Yeah, again, I have replaced x to the standard normal variate formula and I kept mu and standard deviation as it is. And this is equation 2. X is equal to 125 falls in the upper tail. I have considered this as a positive value, and which is equation 2. Now we have to prepare data to plot into the table. For that, let us consider first x is lesser than 60, which means probability of x is lesser than 60 and equals to probability of z lesser than minus z1, because we have negative value to the x is equal to 60, and we know that the respected proportion of x is equal to 60, which means 60 items are 35% of the distribution. So again, we have to remove that negativity from the equation, because we have to look into the upper tail of the region in the table. So probability of z greater than z1 will be equals to 0.35. Since that 35% is purely falls in the lower tail of the region and purely in the one tail of the region, I have to subtract the value obtained from that 0.35 from the 0.5, because it falls in the lower tail of the region. Lower tail belongs to 0.5%. So 0.5 minus probability of 0, because it is symmetric about its mean, lesser than z and lesser than z1, will be equals to 0.35. And when we subtract 0.5 by 0.35, we will get probability of 0 lesser than z and lesser than z1 will be equals to 0.15. And now we have to look table value for this 0.15 value. So here I don't use the z table value, because here the scenario is different. So I have to use another z table, which means inverse z table. When we had mu and standard deviation value, we would generate z value. For that z value, we could use standard normal variate z table. But here, since we are having percentage of x, we have to use inverse table of normal distribution. Inverse in the sense, we have to see the association percentage. So this is a normal distribution inverse cumulative distribution function, which means inverse CDF or ICDF. Firstly, let us know what is inverse cumulative distribution function. So it gives the value associated with a specific cumulative probability. So here directly we won't look into the values. We have to look into the value of specifically associated with cumulative probability. Cumulative in the sense we have to add to the values. So we use inverse CDF to determine the value of the variable associated with a specific probability. Okay, now I will show you how to read this inverse CDF or how to use this inverse CDF. First of all, R value for x 60 is 35% is 0.15. So this is R value 0.15, and which is associated with the value of 0.50. That is what I explained what is inverse CDF. So here again I will tell you, we have to use this inverse CDF to determine the value of the variable. Here our variable is 0.15, and we have to look the value of variable associated with specific probability. Here already is there a specific probability is 0.50, and we have to add the specific variable. A specific variable is 0.15 to the specific probability. So specific probability is 0.5 and specific variable is 0.15. When we add these together, our inverse cumulative distribution function would be 0.65. Now look into the 0.65 here. Here it is our 0.65. For 0.65, our value is 0.3853. Here in the left side, in the left column, we have inverse cumulative distribution function, and here we have the score of that inverse cumulative function. So which starts from 0.50, and our inverse cumulative distribution function is 0.65, which is here, and that respected value is in front of that inverse cumulative distribution function. So here inverse cumulative distribution function is 0.3853. Then let us locate this value to the equation. Now our z1 value is 0.39, which is rounded to the 0.39. So by this way we found x is equal to 60 value, that is z1 value. Now we have to see the z2 value. That is z2 value would be probability of x greater than 125, which falls in the upper tail of the region. So probability of z greater than z2 is 10%, which is in a fraction, that 0.10. So 125 of the item are over 10%. So that is expressed in this equation. So now this 10% and 125 items are also falling in the upper tail of the region. We have to consider one side, which means upper tail value region value. Upper tail value is 50%, that's 0.5. When we express this in terms of probability, when we subtract the value, that 0.1 from 0.5, we would get probability of 0 lesser than z and lesser than z2 is equal to 0.40. When we subtract 0.1 from to 0.5, we got 0.40. And now again we have to look inverse cumulative distribution function for 0.40. As I told you already, there is already a specific probability. For that we need to add specific variable probability. So specific probability is 0.50, here it is, and specific variable probability is 0.40. When we add 0.50 to 0.40, our inverse cumulative distribution is 0.90. For inverse cumulative distribution 0.90, we are having the value is 1.2816. So now let us locate this value also to the equation. So z2 value is 1.28. So by this way, using inverse cumulative distribution function, we obtained z1 and z2 value. Now let us put these two z1 and z2 value into the equation of 1 and 2 and form some other equation. Firstly, I will consider z is equal to z1 value, that x is equal to 60. So for x is equal to 60, we found that z1 value is 0.39. Since it falls in the left tail of the region, lower tail, I have inserted negativity into this value. So this becomes a third equation. By putting the z1 value into the equation 1, we form third equation. And let us also form fourth equation by putting z2 value to the second equation. We know that second equation is z is equal to 125 minus mu and by standard deviation, and we also know that z2 score is 1.28, which falls in the upper tail of the region. So upper tail is positive infinity, so I know that positive infinity, so I kept this value with the positive value, and this has become fourth equation. Now using for third and fourth equation, we have to obtain the values of mu and standard deviation, very importantly. So subtract fourth equation from third equation, which gives, So here 125 minus mu, which is a fourth equation according to the 4 minus 3 equation. And again we have this negative form, negative as a subtraction sign. We have to carry that sign as it is. That 125 minus mu minus, and we have to consider this 60 minus mu. Since there is negativity in the z1 value, minus into minus it becomes plus. So 60 plus mu, and in the either the side we have standard deviation. I carried the standard deviation as it is. And also we have to consider these two values, 0.39 and 1.28. So equals to 1.28 plus 0.39. So when we subtract 125 by 60, we got the value of 65, and standard deviation carried as it is. And when we add 1.28 to the 0.39, we got 1.67 value together of z1 and z2. So we need to find the standard deviation value. So standard deviation is equal to 65 by 1.67. And now we got the standard deviation value. Standard deviation is equal to 38.90. Once we obtain one value, we can easily obtain other value. Now we got the value of standard deviation, and now we can easily find the value of mu using standard deviation value. So for that we have to consider the fourth equation. Also we can consider third equation. Whatever the equation you can consider, the value would remain same. Now I will consider fourth equation for the purpose. So when we consider fourth equation to find the value of mu, here we found value of mu and standard deviation. Standard deviation is already found. Now adding to that is mu is going to be found. Let us consider fourth equation. The fourth equation is equal to mu is equal to 125 minus 1.28 standard deviation. You may be confused how we obtained this value. Here it is a fourth equation. We have considered this equation. The equation is z is equal to 125 minus mu by standard deviation is equal to 1.28, which is written in an equation form that just I showed you. So for the fourth equation, we can add a value before we move further. That value we have already obtained that standard deviation value. So mu is equal to 125 minus 1.28 into that standard deviation value. So standard deviation value is 38.92. Firstly, I have to multiply 1.28 into 38.92. Then I will subtract the value obtained from this multiplication by the value of 125. So finally, we could arrive at a mu value. When we multiply 1.28 into 38.92, we got 49.8176. And when we subtract 125 to 49.8172, we got 75.18. This is the mu value we obtained using fourth equation. By inserting standard deviation value to the fourth equation, we got mu value here. So finally we obtained that mu value and standard deviation. So hence mu is equal to mean is 75.18, which is obtained here, and we know that standard deviation is 38.92. So by this way we obtained mu and standard deviation. Especially when you are not given with the mu and standard deviation, you have to think about inverse cumulative distribution function using 2x value. That percentage in terms of percentage will be given. Using that you can find the value of mu and standard deviation. Thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe to my Vision Academy YouTube channel. Thank you.